Hello everybody, and welcome to a new video, and welcome to my pain and suffering. My dog is a lovely dog, but unfortunately, like all good things in the world, there is absolutely nothing holding us here. Not even like the stuff you have or the lives you live. There's nothing that holds us back here. If you didn't know, I have to put down my dog today. Well, you guys didn't know anyway, but I have to put down my dog today. And he's been in some videos. I don't know what the videos were called, but he's been in some of my videos. And I was always the one to take care of him, or my family didn't. Now, so it's Friday early morning, like it's 2:25 in the morning, and I got this text last night, while I was sleeping, but I have to. Go and make sure he knows he's loved. And then, so today's Friday morning, early morning. On Wednesday, my mother got home and she noticed that he couldn't use his back legs. Arthritis or something, I have no idea. But today we have to go and administer the drugs and then bury him. Because we're not paying, not really like to have him cremated and then not knowing that it's the actual him. Actually him that in there, so we just plant a tree on top of our animals mostly. And we didn't do it for the kitty. But that's basically my life today. I had a new outlook on life, and it just goes down the crapper. So, thank you guys for sticking with the channel. It really means a lot to me, especially in these harder days that I have. That dog was... It meant so much to me, because it was right after my Oma passed away that we got him. Back in 2009, or did she die in 2008? Or 2009? And then we got him right after, so December of 2009, so probably 2010, or we got him in May of 2010, or May of 2019, or 2009. Yeah, so that's basically what is happening today. It's days like this I wish I didn't have pets. I don't have pets now at where I am, but they were at my parents' house, and like it's putting them down, that's the hardest part in their in. Well, it's different for everybody, but for me, it's putting them down is the hardest part. Or like them dying in general is the hardest part for me. And it just proves that there's no one there watching us, like protecting us. Because we're all gonna die sometime. We're all gonna leave this planet. Like, there's nothing we can do about it. We're either gonna leave the planet and ascend to a higher power for some beliefs. And then other beliefs, we're just gonna be reincarnated or something. There's nothing. There's nothing that we can't live as long as like good old ho 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 Santa Claus or the Easter fucking bunny. No, we just die. Complete darkness. If there was a God, people wouldn't be dying from cancer. People wouldn't, and even though that, like, when I did follow, I had a pastor who passed away from cancer, who I was very close to. That's probably why I'm not following religion anymore. But, he ended up dying from cancer, and I'm like, he's spreading the word of your word. Like, why would you take a prophet's life? Like, basically, you did it to your own son who spread the word of God, and now you're doing it to everyone who spreads the word of God and people who don't spread the word of God. Like, there's no, like, other diseases too. There's MS, there's cerebral palsy, there's other diseases that I can't think of right now because I'm too distraught and tired, that are not being not able to be cured because the person that we call a god or whatever that's why I don't believe in that stuff anymore. Because there's no saving people from any disease that they have with him, with the God that we call God. Well, some of us call God. I'm not just. Like it's like my family has had this argument many times over the course of my lifetime. If God was real, why is there so much death and destruction in the world? I know the whole story of the Bible. Don't give me biblical philosophies. I know about Genesis and all that, and the Great Flood and everything in between, and everything to the burning pits of the burning pits of hell to the burning river or lake or whatever in the last book. I know it all. I went through the Bible school or Bible or Sunday school classes, but the point is, if there's a real God, why is there all this death from, like, young kids dying? Like, it's not right that young kids have to perish just because he wants to prove a point or whatever the case may be. It's not, like you say, it's not just cancer. I know people with arthritis so bad that is around my age or even younger. Like, I've heard it, a kid on the news who had arthritis so bad, who's only in grade school still. I think elementary or middle school. And she has arthritis so bad that she has to take medication for it. She has to. And basically do it all. And if there was a God, there wouldn't be all this pain and suffering in CFS and Child and Family Services and basically all the suffering in schools and for with kids like I was suffering in school. There wouldn't be any of that if there was a real God. Like, he's just as real, I'm sorry, kids, as Santa Claus or the Easter Bunny or good old turkey mascot on Thanksgiving. Just as real as Halloween that's coming up just around the corner. I'm gonna hear it all day on the streets of Beauséjour. Basically, there's not gonna be any silence that day. So you're gonna hear in the background of the videos unless Michael edits them out. Michael's not editing this one. This one's just me uploading it, talking. But like I say, if there's a real person out there protecting us, why isn't he protecting the kids in the hospitals? Why isn't he not protecting any of those? It's always the donations to those hospitals that really, really help those kids. No amount of Jesus or anything will ever help because if, and like I say, praying to just the air, which I believe people are ending up doing, and then having the air heal him, heal them. I think it's just the medical profession that healed them. It wasn't anything that any higher power or anything did. So, that's basically what's going through my brain. Yeah, and I tidied up the place. Me and some people came in, tidied the place. So there's that to look forward to. Yeah, so. But thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one. While I sit here and pout and drink, because that's what I need right now, is a nice stiff drink. Anyways, I'll talk to you guys later. Bye bye.